I want to come to the first award, which I think is speaks exactly to what I've been talking about, sort of making those connections, which are so important for people on both ends. So to present the Academic Ally Award, I'm going to turn it over to Kendra Sharp. She's the head of the Office of International Science and Engineering at the National Science Foundation. Kendra, over to you.
Oregon State University. And for over a decade now, I've been part of the academic community supporting engineering for global development. In doing so, I've had the chance to follow a range of academic efforts that support engineering for global development, innovation, and social entrepreneurship. As many of you know, there's often a tension between traditional engineering education and the curricular flexibility, non-traditional approaches, and emphasis on interdisciplinarity and partnerships required in this space. Given this tension and the many associated hurdles, the time and energy required to grow and sustain these programs cannot be understated. Add to that the challenges of working directly with community partners, offering highly time and resource-intensive experiential learning elements, and, well, the work is both intensely challenging and intensely rewarding. Over the course of the pandemic, the need for research that addresses pressing societal challenges at both local and global scales has become even clearer. Many inequities have been laid even more bare, but the current generation of college-age students gives me hope. Many want to work on addressing climate change or poverty or food, water, or energy security or other challenges. And these types of academic opportunities are critical for their development. I have the distinct privilege of serving now as a senior leader at NSF, where we not only drive our strategy for global engagement, but also collaborate with colleagues across the US government and with our international counterparts. Increasingly, themes that emerge in NSF strategy are mirroring what we've been doing in engineering for global development for years, whether it's having a global focus or an emphasis on addressing societal problems or integrating social scientists and collaborating with community partners, or even work where communities themselves drive the research questions and work where equity, inclusivity, and social justice are part and parcel of what we do and how we do it. I like to think that other parts of the research community are just catching up to what this community has been doing all along, namely pushing the boundaries of pedagogy and traditional engineering education and research. Of course, that's a biased view. Even so, I'm very proud of our shared research and education community. And with that, please join me in congratulating Penn State on receiving the Academic Ally Award. This is an award that recognizes visionary academic institutions and their innovative pedagogies and research, their partnerships with ASME, and a shared mission to train the future workforce together. Standing up and cultivating cutting-edge programs in engineering schools is a difficult proposition. Penn State's College of Engineering has demonstrated a long-term commitment to social innovation and ongoing support for the program and its faculty. So thank you for everything that you do for your students, your faculty, the broader community, and our shared profession. And with that, I'm very pleased to present this award to Justin Schwartz, Dean of Engineering at Penn State University, and Esther Adiambo Obonyo. Thank you.
The critical role that engineering has in advancing humanity. And thank you mostly to Impact Engineering and all of those involved in our selection for this prestigious award. On behalf of the Penn State College of Engineering, we gratefully accept the Academic Ally Award. More importantly, we thank you for establishing and amplifying the Engineering for Change Research Fellowship Program. We have enthusiastically supported the program since it started and to partner with E4C to make measurable progress towards the UN Sustainable Development Goals. Much of our work is channeled through our Humanitarian Engineering and Social Entrepreneurship Program, or HESI, and more recently through our Global Building Network, formed as a partnership between Penn State and the United Nations Economic Commission for Europe, and led by Professor Esther Obonyo, implementing solutions for the built environment around the globe. Critically, Penn State students and faculty who participate in both of these programs are not limited to just the College of Engineering. We welcome all students and faculty contributors from across all of our campuses. As we all know, we need all perspectives and expertise to innovate and implement solutions. With participants from every college and every facet of Penn State and beyond, We're enthusiastically supporting projects that apply engineering in ways that improve life for all. We are Engineering for Humanity, and we are proud to partner with E4C in this pursuit. I am personally especially thankful for the leadership of Dr. Esther Avonio, who previously directed HESI and who currently directs the Global Building Network. Professor Avonio, would you like to say a few words as well?
Thank you, Dean Schwartz, and thank you, Kendra. I'll briefly echo Dean Schwartz's gratitude. The E4C program is facilitating crucially important work, and we are proud and thankful to be strong supporters. We are especially proud of our E4C Penn State Fellows, including Julio Diate, who researched the repurposing of cardboard waste to building homes, and Molly Ackman and her team, who worked on developing leading-edge tools for low-cost diabetes screening. I've also had the pleasure of partnering with E4C to mentor and advise two teams of E4C's fellows. In 2020, Sungwe Bang and Julio Diate designed and developed concepts for resilient low-income housing in Kenya and Tanzania. In 2021, Tiffany Lewing and Ali Gazvian advanced these concepts through examining barriers and enablers for scaling the deployment of affordable strategies for resilient housing in Dar es Salaam, Tanzania. This work is part of a Belmont Forum project on disaster risk reduction that is partly funded by the National Science Foundation. The output and outcomes that have come out of the work of E4C fellows is now being used to develop evidence for policymaking in collaboration with the university and the research team of Tanzania's Office of Prime Minister. They are in charge of disaster risk management for the whole country. E4C fellows are generating knowledge for advancing technologies, protecting the planet, and also saving lives. All these incredible feats are exemplified by the outputs and the outcomes of the Penn State Fund partnership with Engineering for Change and ASME. We appreciate the recognition and extend our congratulations to our fellow Impact Engineered honorees. Thank you very much.